is. There's a lot of fundraising. There's a lot of activity and excitement trying to get that organization up and running and doing what it is supposed to do. The next phase is usually maturity. The product is in place, the mission is in place, the people are in place. There are people who have bought into the mission or bought the product and are supporting it, and things are going along at a fairly level of success and activity. There's a plateau typically at that level, and it may go on for years, maybe even decades. But then, as things usually go, things begin to maybe decline a little bit. Maybe the product has become stale. Maybe people have found something else to satisfy the particular need that this product or this mission was providing. Maybe there's some competition that has come into play. And so a little decline begins, and things start going just a little bit less than optimal. And if those things aren't attended to, then the lifestyle will continue into a decline, and maybe then even into termination. We know that at the time of Saints Peter and Paul, the church was being and had been established. This institution, if you want to call it that, was still very young, had received its message, had received its mission from no one else than God. Christ had given the apostles the Great Commission, and their mission statement, if they had one, was to go forth into all the world, proclaiming the good news and baptizing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. That was the mission of the church. That was the product, if you want to put it in crass terms like that. But this was the reason that the church was begun. And this is the reason that the church still exists today. You know that those early times were not always so easy. It wasn't easy from a human perspective to go out and to proclaim the gospel. And it wouldn't have been able to happen if the Holy Spirit hadn't descended, sent by the Son, coming from the Father. Because we know that it's only through the Holy Spirit that anything good can be accomplished. So these leaders of the church who had been appointed, St. Peter certainly being the figurehead, and not just a figurehead, but one who was so inspired by the Holy Spirit that he went out and took the lead role, or a lead role, in proclaiming the gospel and converting people, bringing them to life in Christ. And Paul, who had been converted and brought in a very different way, challenged for what he had believed, challenged for how he had acted by our Lord and Savior himself, shown the light and proclaimed the message and the mission so we know that that was the beginning of the church. And many shared in the suffering of Christ, the one who had given the mission statement. And that was no surprise, as our Lord had told them, that this was part of the territory. This was coming along with the joy of seeing people come to Christ. There would be suffering. And so they personally felt that suffering. Being persecuted themselves, by being imprisoned, by being tortured, and eventually by going to their own martyrdom. But it's this zeal, it's this intensity, when we read the accounts of the books of Acts, that really is the thing that we need to grasp. Because even though that intensity was necessary to begin, to have this startup period in the church, we know that at various points in the life cycle of an institution, intensity needs to return. And I think, my brothers and sisters, that we're at that point now in the life of the church. Not that there haven't been periods, regular periods of intensity and zeal for the faith. But now it seems like it's the time when we're most challenged. Maybe every generation feels this way. But if we look around at the landscape, we know that it's apparent to us that the message not penetrating as well as it could. The message hasn't changed. The mission hasn't changed. The environment has changed. But there are still people who are ordained to preach, to teach, and to baptize. And this isn't only the ordained ministry, but really each and every one of us who have received the Holy Spirit through our baptisms, our chrismations, are all called in some way to have zeal for the faith, to learn our faith, to know our faith, and to live it, even if it's only in the workplace, in very simple ways. We need to continue to infuse ourselves, infuse our lives, infuse our thought process, and really infuse everything that we do with the gospel message. It's only then that it becomes real. It's only then that people see that this is something that they desire, or at least become curious about. St. Peter and Paul, and many among them, many after them, exhibited this zeal. They went to their persecutions sometime gladly. We even hear that St. Peter went joyfully to his execution. It's when we can have this joy in the face of suffering, a joy that's rooted in the good news, in the very mission statement of the church, that the light of Christ shines through into the world. So my brothers and sisters, it's hard to say where we are in the life cycle of the church, but we can be assured that it will never reach that end, that termination. But if it is in decline, in fact, then we need to recapture the zeal of St. Peter and Paul. We need to refocus our lives, realign the hierarchy in our lives, and put our God, our faith in our God, and His salvation and his kingdom first. And let everything else follow, but also be infused by that first thing. These great men of the church inspire us today. So let us not leave the inspiration here inside the walls of the church. Our Lord said, go forth. Let us be encouraged, let us be strengthened, let us be